Hello friends and viewers. Today I am going to talk about how immune system works in our body. In my previous talk, I have shown that many cells are working in our body to protect from the pathogen. And also I have talked about the lymphoid organs, which are very organized in our body to prevent the pathogenic infection. So how these cells and the lymphoid organs are synchronized to prevent the total infection in our body. That is the main talk in this video, and I will explain that how immune system detect a pathogen and mount a total immune reaction. And I will explain that how immune system detect a pathogen and give or mount a immune reaction or immunity to a foreign pathogen. And then I'll talk also the basic characteristics of the immune response that we should know to learn about the immunology. Those are actually very basic things. And the innate and the adaptive immunity. What is the basic difference between the innate and the adaptive immunity? And lastly, the role of the immune system in human. So how actually immune system works in our body? In the normal state, we produce a lot of cell from our lymphoid organ. We know that there are two types of lymphoid organ, the primary lymphoid organ and the secondary lymphoid organ. In the primary lymphoid organ, we have the bone marrow and the thymus. And in the secondary lymphoid organ, we have the spleen, lymph node, and also the Peyer's passages in the intestine, and some other also the tonsil and the adenoids, this type of secondary lymphoid. So in the normal state, this primary lymphoid organ, the bone marrow and the thymus, produce the lymphocyte. And in the bone marrow, most of the cell, I can tell all of the cell, are produced in the bone marrow. And bone marrow is not only here, we have the bone marrow in the long bone, like the hand and the leg and the ribs. So this immune cell, like the eosinophil, basophil, NK cell, dendritic cell, macrophage, B cell, T cell, all are produced in this bone marrow. And only the T cell goes to the thymus for their maturation, and then this T cell and from the bone marrow all other cell come in the circulation. From the circulation, they go to the secondary lymphoid organ, for example the spleen and the lymph node and the Peyer's passage. So in this way, they migrate from the primary lymphoid organ to the secondary lymphoid organ. And in the secondary lymphoid organ, they reside for a couple of days and wait to see that any antigen or any foreign pathogen is coming inside of the body or not. And then they actually die if they don't see any pathogen. So these are the normal phenomena in our body, that how these cells are generated, and then they migrate from the primary lymphoid organ to secondary lymphoid organ, and then they wait and die. So in this way also, most of the cell, they are generated in the primary lymphoid organ, and they also go to the most of the tissue of the body. For example, the macrophage, dendritic cell, and some other tissue resident cell, they go to the specific tissue and then they reside there to see that whether the foreign antigen or foreign pathogen is coming or invading inside our body or not. And then if they don't find, either they die or they stay there for a long time. So these are the normal mechanism. But when a body is invaded by a foreign pathogen, then the whole this system mount a immune reaction. And how they mount this immune reaction, I'm going through this step, like the capture of the pathogen. Where they are captured? In normal state, when a foreign or invader go inside of our body, they come through a different location, like from the skin and from the lung, through the nose, because we always inhale the air, and through the air most of the virus or the airborne pathogen get inside of our lung, and they try to invade through the lung inside of our body. And this can be also the intestine, because through mouth we eat a lot of food, and within this food a lot of pathogen get inside in our body, and the mucosal layer which are in the intestine, they try to not to get inside of our body, the mucosal system, but sometimes when they are infected, the barrier does not work too much. They get inside of body and then we are infected. So in this way, the invader get inside of our body. So in this location, the tissue have the dendritic cell. So the dendritic cell or DC is a good cell for the presentation of the pathogen, because they wait inside of this type of tissue, for example the lung and the intestine, and when this dendritic cell see that a pathogenic bacteria or virus is coming through the nose or the mouth or the skin, they capture those bacteria. And through the phagocytosis is a process through which this dendritic cell eat or engulf this bacteria and fragment it and make pieces. And through this system, this dendritic cell actually kill this bacteria. And not only they kill, they also capture this bacterial fragment and they express on their cell surface. This is the piece of bacteria. So when this dendritic cell capture from the skin or the lung or from the intestine, this dendritic cell migrate through the blood to the secondary lymphoid organ, for example the lymph node, and this is called the migration to the secondary lymphoid organ. This migration is actually mediated by some chemokines. For example, dendritic cell express the CCR7, the chemokine receptor 7. And when this dendritic cell express the CCR7, their ligand is expressed by the secondary lymphoid organ, for example, the lymph node. So they go through the lymph, and when they get inside of the lymph node, they find their ligand there, and then they bind to the secondary lymphoid organ. But as I said, that the T cell, which are produced from the thymus, they are just waiting to see that whether this dendritic cell is coming or not. So they are residing of this lymph node. So when they find that this dendritic cell is coming, so this T cell are activated by this dendritic cell, because this dendritic cell present their surface antigen, which are captured by the degradation of the bacteria to the T cell. T cell have the T cell receptor or TCR, through which this T cell can recognize that, okay, this is the foreign bacterial component, so I have to mount a reaction. So this way dendritic cell present to T cell and T cell get activated. So when T cell get activated, they try to produce a lot of T cell with the same TCR. And when they produce a lot of T cell, like T, 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 those T cell are with same TCR. This is called the clonal selection. Clonals mean same type. Since this TCR the same type, this is called clonal. And the selection means that this specific T cell are selected, and only this type of TCR containing T cell are proliferated and producing a lot of T cell. So after the clonal selection, this T cell go to the B cell zone of this secondary lymph node, and all these are happening in the secondary lymph node area or any secondary lymphoid organ like the spleen and the Peyer's spaces. So there this T cell give the induction of this B cell, and then B cell get activated. And when this B cell are activated, they produce the antibody. And this antibody are specific to those pieces of bacteria that are presented by the dendritic cell. So in this way, the T cell and the B cell get activated. And after activation, from the lymph node, this T cell and this B cell, which are activated and very specific to those bacteria, are released from the lymph node. And T cell, which are CD4 positive and CD8 positive, they release from the lymph node, and especially the CD8 positive T cell go through the circulation to a specific site of infection. If the bacteria was collected from the lung, here the lung, those T cell travel through the circulation and get inside of lung and kill the bacteria and the virus. And the B cell, which produces the antibody. Those antibody are released into the serum, and through the circulation they also go to the lung, and they neutralize the bacteria or the bacterial toxin. In this way, the activated B cell and T cell produce the antibody, or by activated T cell they kill the bacteria which are invaded inside of our body. So this is the overview of the total immune system that works inside of our body when a foreign pathogen try to invade our body. Some basic characteristics of the immune system that we should know to more clarify about the total immune system in our body. Like the specificity. The specificity is a specific property which is defined by that when a bacteria invade inside of our body, our immune system can mount an immune response to those specific bacteria. Like if the bacteria A is coming inside of our body, so our immune system can mount immune reaction to bacteria A. But when bacteria B is coming, those immune response that was produced for the bacterial A, those immune B cell or T cell cannot recognize the bacterial B. They can only recognize the bacteria A. In this way, they are very specific to a specific bacteria or a specific antigen. Diversity. Our immune system can mount a different type of bacteria, like bacteria A, bacteria B, also the virus, also the other pathogen like the parasite. So they are actually diverse, and they have the memory capacity, because when an immune response induced, those B cell and T cell can generate a specific memory B cell and memory T cell which reside inside of our body for a long time period. And when second time this specific bacteria again try to invade in our body, this memory B cell and memory T cell mount a stronger reaction and kill those bacteria very rapidly. So our immune system have the memory. And I have already talked about the clonal expansion, and this is true for also the T and B cell. Both type of T and B cell, when they experience the antigen, they clonally expand and produce a lot of same type of T cell and B cell. Same time means that the TCR and the BCR are same for this clonally expanded cells. Specialization. Specialization is a specific property that when bacteria A is coming, the immune response mount a strong and a huge reaction to bacterial A. And when the bacteria B is coming, the immune system react to the bacterial B strongly. It is not like that A is coming, but our immune system is mounting a reaction to bacterial B. So they are very specialized to a specific type of bacteria or the virus. And the sixth property is the contraction, because when the immune system get activated and the immune response kill the bacteria, our body is normal, and in that state we don't need to extra immune reaction going through for further processing or further forward. That's why this immune reaction need to be stopped after the clearance of the bacteria. So this is the property that after clearance of the bacteria, the immune system reduce their reaction and get to the normal state of the body. And seventh property is the non-reactivity to self. Like the when the immune system reaction is high for the foreign pathogen, they only react to the foreign pathogen, not to the self body cell. Because if they react to the self body cell, then those cell can be destroyed, and they can destroy actually our self. So that's why they are non-self reacting immune response. But when this breaks, it can produce the autoimmunity type disease. And the basic property like the innate and the adaptive immunity, you have to know, because this type of division is always prominent in the immune response in human body and also all over the immune system. The innate immune system are defined by a protection system against infection that relies on mechanism exist before the infection. It means that they were prevalent before the invader comes inside of our body. And the adaptive immune system are defined when the invaders comes inside our body, the adaptive immune system mount after the entry of the pathogen. There are a good number of difference between the innate and the adaptive immune system. Basically, the basic difference is like the innate immune system is the first line of defense, and this is on very early of invading of the pathogen. But the adaptive immune system comes later of the innate immune system, and in this way the innate immune system is not too much specific to the pathogen, but the adaptive immune system is very specific to the pathogen. And the innate immune system has less diversity, but the adaptive immune system has a higher diversity of the pathogen, because the B cell and T cell can produce a lot of BCR and TCR specific to the pathogen. In this way they are become very diverse. The innate immune system do not have the memory, only the adaptive immune system have the memory. An innate immune cell cannot clonally select, but the adaptive immune system like the B cell and T cell, which are under the adaptive immune system, they can clonally select of their specific type of B cell, T cell after the specific bacteria or virus entry. And the specialization is less effective for the innate but more effective for the adaptive immune system. And both the system contract after the clearance of the bacteria and the virus. And the innate immune system is less cell reactive, but the adaptive immune system is more self-reactive. That's why in the more immune disorder or autoimmunity is related to the adaptive immune system. So next we see that the innate immunity, the main component are the epithelial barrier, and the some are the cells like the phagocyte cells, dendritic cells, the complement system, which are always reside in our blood and they are always activating in response to different type of pathogen or non-pathogenic bacteria, and they are giving the protection. The NK cell, which are also in the innate immune system, they produce the protective immunity within 12 hour of the invading of the foreign pathogen. That's why they are called the innate immunity, and they are almost same in the primary immune response and the secondary immune response. The primary immune response is immune response that is the for the first time when the invader comes, and the when the second time the invader comes, those called the secondary immune response. So in these two immune response, the primary and the secondary, this innate immunity is the same magnitude. But for the adaptive immunity, who is comes later after actually one day and give the peak immunity or immune response at the day 5 of the infection, and the B lymphocyte and the T lymphocyte is the major cell type in the adaptive immune response, and the T cell directly kill the bacteria or the virus and the infected cell, and the B cell produce the antibody and kill the cell, and both they are selected by clonal selection. So these are the basic difference of the innate and the adaptive immune system or immunity. And what is the role of this immune system? I can just talk about four different roles, like they defend against the infectious agent like the bacteria and virus. When our body is compromised with the bacteria and virus, or if our body actually have the deficient immunity, the bacteria and virus can win and they can mount a pathogenicity, and like the HIV or AIDS, they can get inside of our body. And also this is true for the other bacteria and the virus also. And the vaccination boost up this immune system before the bacteria or the virus invade inside of our body. In this way, before the infection, we can boost our immune system to a specific bacteria or virus. And that's why when the invader comes, they are looks like the secondary immune response. That's why the immune system knows earlier that this HIV or the other virus or bacteria are coming, and they are known already. So that's in this way the vaccination works. And the second role of the immune system is defense against the tumor. They kill the tumor, especially the CD8 T cell and the NK cell. They try to kill most of our tumor or cancer cell in our body. They also work in the tissue graft rejection process, because when we introduce a separate organ like the liver transplantation or the skin transplantation, they always try to reject through this immune reaction. And the fourth type of role which is played by the immune system, they can produce a lot of inflammation, and this type of inflammation are called the allergic reaction and the autoimmunity, and some are other long-term inflammatory disease. So this type of role is played by the immune system. Hope you have understand that how our immune system inside of our body is mounting a defense against the invader pathogens, and how the basic difference between the innate and the adaptive immune system, and also the basic role of this immune system. Thank you for watching, and subscribe and share and like if you think that this is very easy to understand, and don't forget to share this video.